we can use visual effects graph to create the butterfly for our game. So be sure to use HDRP or URP to follow the rest of the video. Go to your package manager and download and install the visual effect graph. I got a texture from the Unity sample for the butterfly. In the project window, right-click, create, and visual effects, then visual effect graph. This video is not for the beginner. We have a lot of complex math, and you should have experience with VFX graph too. So try to follow me step by step. We are going to create three properties to have more control over the inspector. The first one is for the number of our butterflies. And the second for the amount of space they can fly. And the last is the animation speed of their wings. Delete everything you already have in the spawn system. Then add a single burst into the system, which will spawn a number of particles instantly either once. In Initialize Particle, change the bounds mode to manual and make the bound size bigger. Delete other nodes. And add a set position sphere node, which will calculate position based on an input arc sphere and stores the result in the position attribute based on composition. Change the position mode to volume and link the radius property to the sphere radius. After that, we are going to add a set direction. And for input, we need to get a standard attribute. Here the one we use is the position attribute, which is the position of a simulated element. It should be normalized before the cross product node. Cross product or vector product is a binary operation on two vectors in a three-dimensional oriented Euclidean vector space. To find out more about it, I recommend watch this video on YouTube. Again, we need to normalize the value, and this time vector product will be the output value and position of elements. Then connect the output to set direction input. Now let's add set text index. This operator outputs a unique ID that identifies the particle. We are going to multiply it by 2. Then add a positive number to it. Now this is the animation frame used for sampling flipbook UVs for a rendered element. Add the set random velocity as the last node to initialize particle. In the update particle system, add a force node, mode to absolute. Let's get the element position then normalized and cross product. Now we are going to fill up the second vector with the direction of each element. Now let's multiply that with other values. Get the particle ID of each element and modulo that, which is the operation or function that returns the remainder of one number divided by another. Then let's compare that if the output is 0, return true, otherwise return false. Branch works like an if statement: if it is true, return 4, if it is false, return minus 4. You can change the value if you want to. Then connect this to our multiply node. But we want to force each butterfly to be different, so we can add random number with a minimum of 0.2 and a maximum of 1.2. After that, the output should add with the opposite position. The turbulence block generates a noise field, which it applies to the particle's velocity. This block is useful for adding natural-looking movement to particles. But we don't need to change most of them, only the Y position. For set velocity, we going to get the velocity we already have, and with minimum node always get the lower value. So if it is lower than 0.5, then the velocity length is our output. Otherwise, 0.5 is the output. We can set the scale of each butterfly differently by adding some nodes and connecting them to the set scale, but we really don't need that here, so we do that manually. We could add the set scale to initialize the particle instead of here. With a pivot node, our butterfly can have a circular rotation and it prevents the butterfly from going straight. Okay, that's enough for the update system. Here we are not going to use this output, so delete it and make another one called output particle HDRP lit quad. Or if you are using URP, just leave it as before. Change the UV mode to flipbook and change other settings as I did. In the base color map, we should put our butterfly texture. I think if we make another property for the texture, that should work better for us. And now we can change it in Inspector too. Let's add Orient Advanced, which makes particles orient themselves to face a certain way. It supports several different modes. The advanced mode is particles oriented to a custom particle space defined using two specified axes. The first axis is immutable, and the block uses the second axis to derive the third. It then recalculates the second axis to create an orthogonal particle space. Just go for velocity, then normalize and cross product with values of x0, y1, and z0, and connect it to the z-axis. For the y-axis, we don't need to calculate the cross product, just add a certain number to y. If you can't see vector 3, go to node settings and change it to vector. Then normalize it and connect it to the y-axis. Let's add position node to the output system. Now let's do mathematics again. Add age attribute node, which this operator outputs the time in seconds since the simulated element spawned. And then multiply that by our random number, then do that with wing animation speed too. Both results will multiply with each other. The sine operator calculates the sine of the input in radians. Then let's multiply or divide by a number to make it a smaller number. The last multiply will set the x and z to 0, that's mean we have a y-axis only. The last two nodes will be set angles for y and x. Just add a remap node here and connect it to set angle y. And for X, do that manually, which 12 is good for us. That's it, but we forgot something here. Butterflies have two wings, which means we need to output particles. So let's duplicate, and you should only change the angles to opposite numbers. Change the value of the nodes to get a better result. I know it was confusing, but this method is very cheap and stable. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and share your thought about it. See you next time.